Good morning, children. Children, last class we started with fractions, isn't it? I hope you all understood the concept of fractions, numerator, denominator, everything. Children, today we'll continue the chapter fractions. Children, last class we learned the introduction of fractions, isn't it? I hope you all understood. Children, let's revise now. Children, fractions means a part of the whole, isn't it? Look here. This is the whole part. This is the whole part. When I divide into two equal parts, 1/2, 1/2, half part of a whole, half part of a whole. This half part is represented by 1/2. 1/2 plus 1/2, half plus half equals to whole part. Okay, half plus half is equals to whole part. And here again, if I divide into four equal parts, this is called quarter part. One quarter part of a whole, quarter part of a whole, quarter part of a whole, quarter part of a whole. So this quarter part is represented by 1/4. 1/4. Okay. 1/4 plus 1/4. This. So 1/4 plus 1/4 is equals to half part, and 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 is equals to whole part. Okay, one full part. Now, fraction is always represented by a numerator and a denominator. Numerator and denominator. Numerator always comes at the top, denominator at the bottom. Numerator, denominator is total number of parts. So, numerator is number of parts shaded or unshaded. Denominator is total number of parts. Write in fraction. We are moving into the exercise, children. Write in fraction. First one, numerator. N is numerator. D is denominator. Okay, N is numerator. D is denominator. If you want, I will write like that. Numerator is 6, denominator seven. We know always the numerator comes at the top and denominator at the bottom. So N/D is the rule for fraction, isn't it? So numerator, what is numerator? What is the value for numerator? It is 6. N evlo mainga 6. 6. What is denominator equals to? 7. 6/7 is the fraction. So we got the fraction 6/7. Always write this N/D and write the fraction, children, so that you won't get confused. Okay, numerator by denominator. Understood? Shall we move on to the next sum? Numerator is 2, denominator is 5. I am representing by N and D. Numerator is 2, denominator is 5. So we know N/D. Numerator at the top, denominator at the bottom. So what is the value for numerator given here? Tell me the value for numerator given here, 2. And the value for denominator here is 5, isn't it? So the fraction is 2/5. The fraction is 2/5. Okay, let's move on to the next sum. Look here. I have given denominator is equals to 11. Numerator is equals to 4. We know always numerator comes at the top and denominator at the bottom. So, numerator by denominator. Denominator by numerator, correct? இப்படி கொடுத்துருக்காங்க இல்லையா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டினாமினேட்டர் அப்ப டி பை என் போடுவீங்களா திஸ் இஸ் ராங் ஓகே ஆல்வேஸ் நியூமரேட்டர் கம்ஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் கம்ஸ் அட் த டாப் அண்ட் டினாமினேட்டர் அட் தி பாட்டம் சோ நியூமரேட்டர் பை டினாமினேட்டர் இப்படி கொடுத்திருந்தா கூட இஃப் தே ஹேவ் கிவன் லைக் திஸ் ஆல்சோ யூ ஹாவ் டு ரைட் இன் திஸ் ஃபார்ம் ஒன்லி நியூமரேட்டர் அண்ட் டினாமினேட்டர் ஃபார்ம் ஒன்லி So numerator at the top, denominator at the bottom. Okay, children. So what is numerator here? 4. What is numerator? N is equals to 4, isn't it? So write 4. Denominator 11. So write 11. 4 by 11. 4 by 11 is the answer. What is the answer? 4 by 11 is the answer. So, in the confusion, miss in the n by d, always numerator at the top and denominator at the bottom. If you put it, you can easily take that number and write it at the correct position. Okay, always numerator at the top and denominator at the bottom. Understood, children? Now, children, you tell me, what should I do now? First, I have to write yes, numerator by denominator. Yes, next, what should I do? I have to find for the n value, numerator, isn't it? What is n here? N is equals to 2. So, I have to write n is equals to 2 by denominator. D is equals to 9. So, 2 by 9 is the fraction. So, one day I am asking you to write n by d, numerator by denominator. You can get the fraction very easily without any confusion. Understood, children? 2 by 9 is the answer. Write the fraction for the shaded portion. This is the question. So, we have to write the fraction for the shaded part. Okay. Here, we have to write the fraction for this figure. Now, we know n by d, numerator by denominator. Denominator represents the total number of parts. So, calculate the number of total, the number of parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How many parts are there? 12. Total number of parts, 12. Now here, we are going to total the number of parts shaded. Number of shaded portion. Okay, so calculate the number of shaded portion. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Shaded portion is the number 5. So, write that in the numerator. So, 5 by 12 is the answer. Okay, we got the fraction for the shaded portion. The answer is 5 by 12. 5 by 12. The next one, again write n by d. You know, d is the total number of parts, n is the number of parts shaded, isn't it? So, calculate the total number of parts. 1, 2, 3. The total number of parts are 3. Number of parts shaded? Only one part, isn't it? So, write 1. 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is the fraction. This is the answer. Okay. The next one. Children, I am writing this numerator by denominator in order you won't get confused. It is easy for you to write the answer, to identify the answer easily. Okay. So, for that one, I am writing this numerator by denominator. Okay. So, D is total number of parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts totally. Isn't it? N is number of parts shaded. So, 1, 2, 3. How many parts shaded? 1, 2, 3. So, 3 parts shaded. It is 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is the answer. 3 by 4 is the fraction we got for the shaded part of the figure. Okay. Children, this is how we have to write the fraction for the shaded portion. Okay, if you write this numerator by denominator, it will be easy for you to take and write the answer correctly, okay? Until you get practice, okay? Write like this and write the answer so that you won't get confused. Puriyudhamma? So, in the mari eduthum bodhu confuse agamattinga. In the sum pannum bodhu sari, modhala namma pannum illaya writing fractions. And the sum pannum bodhu sari. So, write this numerator by denominator so that you won't get confused. Numerator, always it comes at the top. Denominator comes at the bottom. So, keep that in mind and do the sums. Okay, children. Shall we do two more examples? Yes. Go. Children. Now, I am writing numerator by denominator. Denominator is the total number of parts. So, we have to count the total number of equal parts in this figure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So, n is number of parts shaded. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ethana parts ma? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts are shaded. So, write n is equals to 4. D is equals to 9. So, the fraction is 4 by 9. The fraction is 4 by 9. So, we got the answer 4 by 9. Okay, children. The next one. N by D, that is numerator by denominator. Denominator is total number of parts, isn't it? So, total number of parts 1, 2. 1, 2. 2. So, numerator, number of parts shaded. That is, only one part is shaded. That is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is the fraction. So, we got the answer as 1 by 2. Highlight the answer like this. Okay. Children, I hope you all understood how to write in fraction when numerator and denominator is given and how to write the fraction for the shaded portion. Okay. Next class, we'll see how to write fraction for the unshaded portion and how to shade for the fraction given. Okay. See you all in the next class, children. Thank you.